But you a whole NFL linebacker, bro! This video is brought to you by The Off Tatum Store. The Off Tatum Store, get the link in the description section. Let's get into this. Ladies and gentlemen, here we go again with another man transitioning to a female and killing these women. He killing them. Debo style. Running through these women in these sports. Now, let me give you a little context in the background before I get too deep into this, because I'm consistently frustrated and just put off by how sports teams and sports organizations are allowing this to happen. It is completely unfair. But this person who was born Callum Mouncey, Callum Mouncey is the person's name, now it's Hannah Mouncey, but was born Callum. 25 years of his life, he was a man. 25 years of his life, he beast molding in the weight room. And then he actually played, he was what they would call a handballer for an Australian team. I watched the whole documentary. I watched the video and he was pretty solid. Big dude. I'm talking 6'2", 220. This dude is my size. And then all of a sudden, now this ain't up to me to judge or to know. I don't know what that person feel in their mind, but all of a sudden this person wants to be a female. And now his name is Hannah. And this is the thing that gets me and it bothers me about the whole thing, right? Where do you draw the line at between people who really want to transition, people who really want to be women, and people who are doing it because there's some type of an advantage to do so? This person, named Hannah now, literally said on the 60-minute special that he ain't doing no reassignment surgery.
But she decided against gender reassignment.
Have you finished the transition?
Oh, look, I am transitioned. You know, hundreds of thousands of dollars of cosmetic surgery and, you know, reshape their jaw and, you know, have surgery on their voice box and get breast implants and all sorts of stuff. You know, I'm definitely not going down that path.
Hormones is the only thing you're going to do. He's not going to get the throat thing checked. Not going to get the jawline fixed, not going to get nothing on the chest, and ain't going to get nothing down under. Nothing. Say they ain't doing none of that. And so how is it, and then also on the put the icing on top of that, this person said he loves women. So he still loves women. He's not going to change his package. He ain't going to add to the package. He's not going to do nothing else to modify the framework, but he wants you to believe he a girl. Let's get to the sports. Now Hannah, who used to be Callum, is now playing female sports on a female rugby team. Now, any video you watch, this dude is like twice to three times the size of these women. Big old linebacker legs. Big old Debo shoulders. Running through these girls. I'm talking about like me going and playing peewee football. That's how he running through people. Now, of course, he's probably not a great athlete, so he's not going to just kill them. But the size, strength, athleticism is leaps and bounds beyond these girls. And the controversy behind all this, and the controversy with all this, if you do the research, I'm going to help you. I'm going to do it for you, is that the AFL, I think it was the AFL or the Women's League that's associated with this, the Australian Women's League or whatever, he was going into the draft and they said, cuz you way too big. And you are too big and you put the women at risk of you breaking their necks because it's a physical sport and you clearly have a physical advantage. Now let's get to the scientific argument behind this that people like to throw out that I would adamantly oppose and I'm going to push back on. They always use the philosophy of saying when a person takes hormones or whatever, they lose X amount of strength and power, right? Which is true. They do lose a significant amount of their strength. But what is also true is that you had 25 years of essentially taking steroids. And when I say steroids, I mean the testosterone that flows through the male body. You 25 years of running, working out, all that comes with being a man, muscle density, bone density, lung capacity, all of those things that you have had as an advantage for 25 years, and then you somehow take some hormones and lose a little bit of your strength, you're still probably 20 times the strength of some of these women, even after hormones. You don't just go to zero, man. People just lying to you. And also what I found out is that the hormones do not negate your leg strength. Your leg strength don't leave you. That's why trans cyclists still be killing it, because although their body becomes feminine and they lose probably arm strength and upper body strength, they don't lose leg strength. And if you're playing rugby and you're not losing leg strength, then you're still just as effective as you were when you were, a man or whatever, however you want to divvy it out. I'm not here to be mean or be mean to or belittle trans people. I'm not here to do that. All I'm here to do is fight for what's fair. And it's not fair for men to be playing in female sports. And if you somehow now identify as a woman, then you can't put yourself in a category as biological women, women who have been women from the beginning. You can't put yourself in a category with them, because they have always been women and they have always been at a disadvantage for 20 some years while you were stacking it and putting the weights on and doing all this other stuff. It's just not fair. And you live in America, this person lives in Australia, you can do whatever you want to do, you can live your life. The sacrifice of transitioning at 25 years old is the sacrifice of, you may have to sacrifice some things that you like doing. Life ain't finna be perfect for you, and it's not perfect for anybody. People that want to bodybuild and they want to build a muscle, they want to take steroids. Well, you if you want to go down the path of taking steroids because you want your body to look a certain way, maybe you have body dysphoria or whatever, you got to compromise playing sports because it's not allowed in the sports. If you're a big old dude and you want to transition to be a female, one thing that you're going to have to give up is you're going to have to give up competing against other females because it's not fair. And I'll end it with this. This is a women's rights issue. This is a female right issue. Feminists should be jumping all over this. They should be all up in this. Because these men, whether they feel this way or they play in the system, they are literally taking women out of sport. They are literally smashing and destroying their records. Women do not have any place in their own sport anymore because of men. Women have been fighting for rights for I don't know how long. And good men like myself and others who obviously voted for them to have right to vote and all this other stuff have acknowledged that women deserve to have an equal opportunity to compete in their own sports. You ain't never going to see no women playing NFL football. Not one woman in the WNBA could probably make the bench in the NBA. Definitely not going to be nobody playing in the MLB. Because I didn't see that underhand pitch they be doing in the women's league, and that ain't gonna cut it in the MLB. So women can have an opportunity. We let them have their own sports where they can dominate, have their own records. The stuff that they're doing now, ladies and gentlemen, if we don't put this to an end, if we don't stop this, if we don't come against these things, women's sports will be destroyed forever. And God knows how long it's gonna take for other things like this to be unraveled and women be unfavorable as it relates to men who want to be women. Let me know what you think. Is B. Tatum tripping or am I on or something? But I really do think this is a problem. Let me know in the comment section. The links to all of the articles that I read will be in the description section. Like and subscribe to the channel. Hit the bell. Y'all know what it is. Visit The Austin Tatum Store. The Austin Tatum Store, where you get your cool merch. I see y'all in the next one.